everyone. Trish here with Divine Journey Yoga in Tucson, Arizona, and it is hot in the summer. And this practice today is what I like to call low and slow. And I always just take requests, and I teach this class on Zoom. And today the request was to work on our IT band, which is the muscle and the tendons that run down the outside of the legs all the way down to the shin. So we'll see how it goes. And you are welcome to modify and get creative. The energy is really slow and quiet, so take your time and enjoy. Let's stay sitting and just kind of welcome ourselves to this moment. You can look around, you can close your eyes, anything you like. You can rock a little bit. All week long, when I find myself rocking as I teach, I think, oh, I get to do lots of rocking on Friday. I just love that, so comforting. As you slowly start to realize that there's nowhere else to go or nowhere else to be, nothing else to do, just be here for a moment. And sometimes we have to start slowly. Sometimes being here can all of a sudden bring up stuff that we've been ignoring, so it's okay to keep ignoring. Just notice your breath. Notice your body moving. Maybe you're rocking, maybe it's just the movement of the breath. Trying to breathe through your nose more than through your mouth. If it feels like a good idea, start to find a place of stillness, and that might mean you have to wiggle a little more or rock a few more times. Coming to center, feeling the length of the spine, but not engaging a lot of musculature to keep the spine tall. Just let yourself sink a little. Take a full deep breath in, and as you feel the air rise up, complete the inhale and pause. Feeling the fullness, the stillness of the inhale, and whenever you like, slowly let it go. Feel free to add that little bit of ujjayi, tightening in the throat. It sounds like the H sound or a sigh. With the mouth closed, you can hear the breath. Constricting the breath a little bit can sometimes help focus on it. And we're just going to do this several times. Inhaling, pausing at the top of the inhale. And letting go whenever you like. Feel free to bring the pointer finger to the thumb. That's how we started our week. In our Janana Mudra, that circular unity of the body and the mind, the pointer finger and the thumb coming together there. Maybe try one more breath where you pause. Letting the breath settle back into its rhythm. You can open and close the hands. And I'd like to just lean forward, maybe into a child's pose, or even just a forward fold with your legs crisscross, or maybe a square pose. We're just noticing our hips, just settling in, kind of bowing down. If you'd prefer that child's pose, feel free. Continuing to listen to the sound of your breath. When you inhale, feel the back of the body rise and fall on the exhale. Rock your forehead side to side a few times, massaging the center, that third eye point. Feel your temple as you roll all the way to one side and then the other. And if you're not in a position for that, you can always put your hands on your forehead and just kind of roll the weight side to side there. And slowly come up into a table pose. So gently spreading the fingers, placing the feet. We won't be here very long. We're just gonna bump the hips side to side, feeling into the outer edges. We're gonna be working a little bit on our IT band today. So that is the outer tendon that runs from the outside of the hip down the side of the leg. Always makes me think of a racing stripe on a pair of leggings. That's pretty much the length of it. Keep bumping your hips side to side and let your head hang down. Let your shoulders kind of sag a little bit. Keep the shoulders fairly still and drop the belly as you swing the hips once more to each side. Come to center and round the back gently. Start with the tailbone, tucking it under, and then adding the lift of the rib cage and drop that head still. Now swing side to side a few times in this rounded cat pose. Feel free to swing your shoulders a little more. We're going really slow here. Just enjoy the moment. You can always add in more if you feel like you need more speed or more warmth or doing less to stay cool. It's always a good idea. Come back to center and this time lift the head as you lift your tailbone and let the belly and the chest sag. Let the shoulders kind of squinch up onto the back of the body so you're kind of pointing them toward the back of your head. And you can move here if you like. I like to stay still. And my wrists are just starting to get tired. So I'm gonna come back to center and I'm gonna come up onto my fingertips. I'm gonna curl my toes under and rock my hips back and forth so I take some of the weight out of my hands. And then come up and down a few times. Feel free to move the pelvis, move the head, feel the shoulders. One more time, sinking back. And in this reaching back position, walk your fingertips a little further forward. Feel free to let your shoulders follow along and your head and lift the tailbone and drop the chest. We're moving really slowly into puppy dog pose here. You can drop the elbows, keep the hips high. You can roll your forehead or turn your cheek. Take a big breath up the spine. And then as you let it go, sink a little deeper into the shoulders, just letting them soften. And another inhale. On the exhale, lifting up, we're just gonna rock onto our elbows and our knees. Toes are still curled under, maybe the feet are flat. I'm gonna start to crawl my elbows forward, moving through a really quick plank, just feeling the belly pull up as I slowly lower the front of the body down to the floor. Yeah, so we're just moving down into Sphinx pose. We want to go really slow. I'm going to rock my hips a little side to side. We're going to do a little twisting. Rocking the hips and turning the shoulders feels really good. So whatever that feels like to you, I'm kind of turning one shoulder, lifting, pushing it toward the top of the mat. The other shoulder kind of pushes down the long edge. And then the other side, you can feel that side stretch. That feels so good. You can look over the shoulder, see if you can see your toes or your heels. Coming back to center, just reach out with one arm and kind of lean onto that rib. Take the other hand, slide it right next to your chest and gently push your shoulder up just a little. Keeping the hips pretty heavy, you can lay the head down. You can walk the hand out a little further in front of you so you can get a little more, I don't know, a little more stable position. There you go. We're just stretching and twisting the front of the body. Oh my goodness, that feels good. And then slide the other hand long. Just try the other side, rolling under the ribs, playing with that stretch. Come on back to your belly. And just make a little pillow for your chin or your forehead with your hands, your elbows bent. And let's just bend our knees a few times, maybe together or one foot and then the other, just feeling the weight shifting a little bit from hip to hip. And let's roll over onto our side. Take a moment in that seed pose. Think of something good just for a minute, something that you love. And then scoot yourself toward the front edge of that mat and roll onto your back. And look around for your strap so you can find it. Resting on your back, find a good position and just breathe. Settle in, acknowledging the slowing down of our practice this morning. Feel free to sigh on the exhale. Immediately my knees start to rock. It's just so natural now. When I'm on my back, I love to rock my knees. Letting the shoulders get soft, the hands relaxed, the jaw soft as well. Maybe roll it around a little bit. Make a big ah with your mouth and an oh, stretch those lips. Good. Come on back to center with your knees and pull them into your chest so that you're really getting a nice squeeze on the abdomen and a little curling up of the tailbone so you can kind of spread the low back out as you rock side to side. Seeing how that feels. Let's do a little pelvic tilting with our feet in the air. We're going to just cup our hands over our kneecaps and slowly push the knees away. The toes don't even touch the floor, but the back arches just a little. Take a breath in. On the exhale, pull the knees into the chest, pushing all the air out, straightening out the low back, lifting tailbone a little bit. And just back and forth, this is our apanasana. Apanasana. It makes me think of open and close, like a bellows. And strangely, even though this is a very simple movement, there is work going on. You can probably even feel a moment of a little bit of work in the core. The next time your knees come in, just go ahead and keep them there. Keeping the right knee held in, lift the left leg up and roll the ankle. And then just kind of soften into this shape. You don't have to hold the knee in tight. You can just even take your hands down. It doesn't matter. And we're going to play with the foot that's in the air. So first just point the toes and then flatten the foot, keeping them in line with the shin. Okay. And then keep the foot flat finally, and then rock the foot side to side. You can kind of feel the ball of the foot roll in, the outer edge roll out, and you should start to feel a little bit of something going on out here on the outside of the shin, maybe even down the side of the leg. We're going to start to say hello to our IT band. So then roll the ball of the foot inward and start to rock the leg across the middle line of the body. So it just barely goes across. So you're pulling it up, turning the foot inward a little bit. Can you feel that on the back of your leg there? That's your IT band. Oop, not too long. Okay, bend the knee. Bring it down, rock side to side. I almost got a cramp. When you start to feel those cramps, pull away. You don't have to stay for a cramp. We're gonna hold the left knee in now and lift the right leg up and just roll the ankle, play with the foot for a minute. You can squeeze the knee for just a second and then let it go soft, the hips soft. You can rock your head a little. And then we're flattening up the foot and pointing the toes. So we're really engaging all those gorgeous little tendons up and down the leg. Flattening the foot out, rock it side to side a little bit. And that just, if you don't have to do it perfectly, it just means a side to side movement, okay? And then flattening the foot, roll the toes inward a little and then start to cross the foot over. Ah, right into that stretch. Take a breath or two. And then let the foot come back and bend the knee and rock side to side. All right, hello IT band. Okay, looking for the strap, pick it up and wrap it around both of your feet. And of course, you don't have to use a strap. You could just push your feet up and hold onto the backs of your legs. That works too. I'm going to wrap the strap around the ball of both of my feet. My ankles are touching, my knees are touching. There's a lot of pressure between the knees there. And I'm just gently gonna play with my legs a little bit, pulling them in and out a little. Not too quick, kind of a nice slow movement. You can rock bigger, close in toward the head and then farther away so you really get that pelvic tilt going a little bit. And you might even feel a little rowing movement in the arms. You might. It's okay if you don't. And then let's come to a neutral position with the legs where they're not really stretching. They're just kind of relaxing. And slide the left leg out and just let it float down. Take a long time as if it's a leaf taking its time, floating down. And then you can let the leg hover, take a breath or two, and then let the leg rest. Try to let the low back rest as well, taking some of the pressure out, letting the leg that's in the strap get a little bit soft. And slowly start to rock the legs side to side, right to left. So we're gonna be tapping into that IT band here. Not too much, keeping the foot really flat. Keep the toes in line with the shin. It's pretty easy to do with the strap. And feel free to go wider and wider. And eventually even cross the leg over and let the hip roll off the floor, roll onto that bottom hip. You can go as far as you want, side to side, or just stay small in the middle. It's really up to you how that feels this morning. We're gonna be here for at least 4, 5, or 6 breaths. The next time your leg starts to cross over the middle of your body, let it keep going and roll into the leg over twist. Let the shoulder follow, let the hip follow, and maybe let the foot touch the floor and let the knee bend, and you can kind of release the strap. You can even let it go completely. So the knee is really far out ahead of us. And you can rub up and down that outer leg, that IT band area. There's so much more involved here though. There's the piriformis that crosses through the musculature of the glutes. There's all the tendons connecting down into the hamstrings. The legs are such a beautiful combination of so many things. Let's take the top arm up or twirl our wrist around a little bit, maybe bend in the elbow. And then take the arm and move it through the shoulder. Maybe let the hand roll back behind you so you get a little bit of a chest opening, and the shoulder might start to get heavy and roll back, and the knee might rise up a little bit, the leg might straighten. Anything here is fine. Take a big breath right through that twisting center part of the body. And slowly bring the arm back and reach it straight over the head. Take the arm that's underneath and tuck it under your head. So now you're really lying on your side with the knee forward still. You can bring the foot in a little bit if that feels better. Stretching through the shoulders, we're just kind of squeezing the sides of our head with our biceps there, triceps. Another big breath. And then we're going to drag the bottom foot and slide it under the top knee so that the knees are stacked in seed pose, rocking a little bit. Let's rock onto our elbows. Stretch a little into a twisted sphinx pose here. Knees off the edge of the mat. We're on our elbows. Just a little rocking. My favorite place to rock. You can let the head hang. Slowly pushing up. Bring your strap with you. We're just gonna lie down on our backs at the other end of the mat. So again, let the back soften, let the knees rock a little as you assimilate or acclimate to this new position. Maybe even look around and see the room from this different perspective. Let's pull the knees slowly into the chest, give ourselves that squeeze, a hug, rocking. This time, let's make some circles with the knees. Push them away over to one side, down through the middle, over to the other side, and pull them in a couple times in one direction, please. And then, of course, the other. And if you find a spot that you like, stay a little longer. If there's spots that you're like, oh, I need to get through that one quicker, of course, do that. Slowly coming back to center, holding the right knee in, lifting the left leg up, roll the ankle, wiggle the toes. You can wiggle both feet, roll both ankles. Take a deep breath in and slowly let the long leg float down to the floor. Let it hover for a moment, feeling your core is still there, and then let it go. Let it rest. Rocking the knee that's drawn in a little bit, side to side. And slowly breathing, just pull that long leg in, bend the knee, hold onto that knee and lift the right leg up. Roll the ankle around a little bit and lower slowly to the floor. Pulling that right knee back into the chest. We're gonna look around for our strap again. Hopefully it's nearby. And we're gonna wrap it around both feet once again. Both feet are up. Play a little, pulling in and out just a bit. This is our hello hamstrings. And you might even feel it around the outer edges of the hips, up into the low back, because everything is connected. Let the back of the head settle. Let all the muscles that are touching the floor feel the floor beneath them. I love the idea of feeling the floor rise up to support you. And we're going to slide the right foot out and let it come down. Feel free to stretch it out when you're ready. And rock the leg in the air side to side. Again, we'll be here for 5 or 6 breaths, rocking as big or little of movement as you like. One more breath. And as you finish, just let the leg roll over toward the floor onto that bottom hip. Stretching the leg, bend the knee if you like, let the strap go. And we'll just play with our fingers, lifting the top arm up, letting that front leg just rest. The bottom leg can bend a little too. Twisting the wrist, getting into the elbow. Shoulder until you're ready to open the shoulder back behind you. Maybe let it touch the floor as that top leg readjusts so that we can open into that heart twist. Deep breath. Slowly transitioning the arm into a reaching over the head position. The bottom arm slides under the head. We roll onto our shoulders and we restack the knees. Seed pose. Pausing, maybe rocking a little bit. We're going to roll forward onto elbows. Rocking shoulders and hips. Maybe the hips and the knees get moved a little bit too. Long, slow breaths here. Maybe the head hangs. Pushing up nice and slow. Let's find something to sit on, a blanket or a pillow. And we'll just stretch the legs out. See how that feels. Wiggle your toes a little, roll your shoulders a little bit. That's the first half. Hopefully you felt your body kind of sink into the slower rhythm and you're a little more ready for that. Some days my brain slows down quicker than others. Let's just go ahead and bend the knees a little bit and rock from hip to hip, keeping the legs kind of rocking together, keeping the spine straightened out, a little bit of strength in the core, not too much work going on here. Leaning back a little bit, squeezing the shoulder blades just a little. Get that heart stretch across the front of the chest. And then settling your legs, walk the hands even further back, further and further back, so that you get maybe a little bend in the elbows. And keep your eyes looking down at your toes. So you're getting a little bit of a shoulder stretch, maybe even rock a little shoulder to shoulder, bend elbow and straighten elbow. Good. And sitting up again. Let's take one leg in and keep the other leg stretched out. Sitting up nice and tall. The hips are pretty much square here. I've been talking about square hips lately, and I like the idea of a little beam of light, not a cutting beam of laser, just a light shining through one side of your hip and out the other. And as long as the lights come straight out one side and the other, you're in a square hip position, just like square shoulders. If you move one hip back or the forward, that light changes direction, right? And that's what we're doing. We're gonna stay fairly centered here, fairly in a square hip position. And then leaning a little bit down the long leg. We're gonna play a little bit like we did on our back with our foot. So we're gonna flatten it and point it a few times, up and down, yep. And you can do it with your hand too. That feels pretty good. Flatten and point. The fingers can go all the way down though, right? Yeah. Okay, and then let's let the hand do whatever it wants, resting or floating around. And we're gonna rock the foot side to side. You can do this with your hand as well. Tick, tock, tick, tock. And then come on back to center. And now take the foot and kind of twist it side to side a little bit. You can even, if it feels okay for your back, you can reach down and kind of turn the foot, twisting it side to side a little. And that'll get into those tendons a little bit there. And you can do the same with your hand, a little twisting side to side. And then stop and come on up. We're just gonna bend that knee and rock the hip a little bit. And while we're here, let's get a little rocking going on into our hip. So I'm going to reach down for this foot that's in front of me and grab the sole of the foot and the outside of the knee or the thigh, and pick the leg up and rock back and forth a few times. And you can move the hip around in little circles. We want to try to flatten out the foot. It wants to sickle sometimes. Just try to flatten it up so the toes stay in line with the shin. And roll around a little bit. It's okay if your back rounds a bit. If you want to stay in a longer spine, you're gonna wake up your core a little more there. Okay, and lift the leg up. You're holding it with the opposite hand, right? My right leg, my left hand. This is an IT band stretch right here. And swinging it a little bit side to side. The other hand could come down, lean back a little if it feels better. The knee can be quite bent, or you can straighten it out and play a little with that. All right, and we are going to cross it over the knee on the floor and come into a little cow's head, knees generally stacked. It's not an exact. And the outer edges of both feet on the floor. And then we're gonna lean a little deeper into that hip. Getting that whole hip area opening. It's a funny way to open because we're compressing it a little bit, but it's getting stretched because it's connected to the back. Yeah, maybe rock the shoulders a bit. Let's add a little arm work here too. So my right leg is on top, so I'm gonna put my left elbow on top of my right knee and then cross my right elbow on top of that left one. Getting a little twisty here. If it feels good, do it. If not, feel free to sit up, give yourself a hug, come deeper into your eagle pose. If you like how it feels rounded, that's fine to stay there. As you breathe here, you might need to rearrange a little, it's okay. As you breathe, feel the stretch right across the shoulder blades, right around the heart level of the chest. And let that go. Slowly unwinding. We're just gonna pick that leg up and send it back behind us in a zigzag pose. Good. That hip should feel pretty interesting. You can rub it a little bit. And I'm gonna rock a little side to side. I'm just gonna kind of get my elbows involved here. I know it looks kind of funny. Looks like we represent the lollipop kids. I don't know, that's a really old one, you guys, but that's what this reminds me of. You can get the arms involved, do a little, I don't know what this move is called, but it's a dance move there, yeah. Just gonna have some fun. And look at your hips, they're doing something while we're having fun with the arms, good. All right, come on back to center. Lift up through the crown of the head, maybe just feel the hips a little, let them move, let them be loose, and start to walk forward, crawling forward. And you can stay up on your hands, you can drop onto your elbows, just kind of go slow enough so that you can feel the low back, and feel free to kind of walk over toward that front bent knee a little bit more to loosen up the hip that's bent back. Yeah. Another breath or two here. Feel free to rock and go deeper and deeper. And slowly come on up and let's try the other side. Let's see if I can remember. Pick the knees up, stretch the legs out, just kind of rock a little. We're just evening things up a bit. And stretch those legs out. And we'll bend the right knee and place the foot to the inside of the long leg. And then we're just gonna flatten and point the long leg. Again, now you can do it again with your hand on this side. Up and down in that wrist. It's always good to remember the wrists and the fingers in our practice. Coming back to center, we're just gonna go side to side with the hand and the foot. And maybe if you feel like you're slouching a little, just lift the heart a bit. And then come back to center and just kind of twist a little side to side, or you can put the hand flat and swing it side to side. And the foot, I'm trying to twist it a little bit. It's really hard to describe this movement. It's a little bit of movement there, yeah. Okay. And let the foot rest, let the hand rest, and lean into the stretch for a bit. Just a breath or two. Starting to bend the knee and bring the foot to the floor. We're gonna grab hold of the sole of the foot and the outside edge of the knee and lift and rock our baby here. Now, some people take the, I don't even know how they do it. They can somehow get their knee in their armpit and they can get the foot in the other elbow. I don't even know. It's not important. It hurts my back, so I don't do it. I just stay here and I'm really working on lubricating that hip joint. And remember where we went from here? Eventually we're gonna cross the leg over. So I'm kind of repositioning the bottom knee so that when I bring the foot across, it's in that little bit of stacked position. We call this cow's head pose, gomukhasana. I'm just rocking my hips a little. I might lean into it a bit. At any point, you can move into your arms and it's opposite of the feet. So left leg on top, or opposite of the legs, left leg on top, right elbow underneath. Oh, look at that, it's not that opposite. Anyways, we're just having fun with our elbows and our shoulders. Feel free to lean or sit up. Breathe into that mid-back. Slowly. Letting go on the exhale or the inhale. Leaning way back. You can wiggle the toes a little. We're gonna pick that foot up. I'm kind of in between a leaning back and a sitting up. I'm gonna take that foot and bend it back behind me. nice and slow. Lean a little, rock a little. Remember our lollipop kids, just a little bit of elbows. Oh my gosh, that looks great. Okay. I love those side stretches. And eventually leaning into the forward fold, maybe walking a little more over toward the front knee, coming down as deeply as you want. Slowly walking the hands back in and coming up. I'm just gonna pick up both knees and plant both feet nice and wide. I'm gonna do a little seated squat. Feel free to rock a little bit. I wanna move into a real squat pose. So I'm gonna kind of rock myself up onto my heels, my toes. If this is okay for your knees, stay here. If not, stand up right away. You don't have to stay in squat. I'm gonna rock a little bit side to side, getting my feet in there, my hips, my knees. And I wanna come into a standing forward fold. This is our only stand. I know we never stand up on Fridays, but it's not really about the standing here. So I'm gonna turn sideways so you can kind of see me a little bit better. I'm just gonna slowly push my hips up, step my feet a little wider, keep the knees really bent, leaning forward. And let's move stuff off of our mat. So I've got lots of room, bringing the elbows to the thighs. And then coming up a little higher. Shoulders are gonna be above the hips. We're not gonna stand all the way up. We're gonna walk our feet together. See if we can get them close together. And then start to scoot one foot forward, kind of forward of the other foot, and start to heel toe it across. I know, in front of the other foot. And then here's where we're gonna play. We're gonna play with the knees. We're just bending, straightening, leaning. Lean forward again, and you might grab blocks. You might come out of the pose and go grab your blocks and bring them back and place them under your hands. Because what we wanna eventually get to is a little bit of opening in the knees so that you're actually really stretching out that IT band here. But I like it in a standing position because you can swing the hips a little bit more and really feel how that IT band is connected up into the whole group around the hip and the low back. All right. Good job. And then let's go ahead and uncross. Let's come down to hands and knees so we can just let go of the work of standing. Yeah. Take a couple breaks, a couple breaths. Tip the tailbone up and down a few times. And then we'll try the other side. Walking the hands in, curling the toes under. Feel free to stand up any way you like. Get a little higher. If you need to stand all the way up, it's okay. You can. Maybe that would feel good. You can just stand up for a minute. Rock a little. Okay. And we're going to start to move the other foot forward, cross it over, and then come into that forward fold, kind of rocking in the hips, rocking the weight of the feet. And I can never decide if it's the front leg or the back leg that gets more involved here. You can decide that for yourself. Yes. Let the head hang. Another breath or two. And slowly walk yourself forward. You can come back down. You can uncross the legs, of course. Then come to table. Rocking those hips. I'm gonna just flatten my feet and sit back on my feet. If you would rather do child's pose, that's fine too. Just gonna sit for a moment, feeling those hips. Got just one or two more fun things to do with our IT band. So we're just kind of touching it, stretching it a little, and coming out. We're not really stressing it out. We're just like, hello, and then goodbye. So hopefully that won't be too much. Just rocking a little. And then slowly coming back to table pose. I'm gonna walk my knees back a little bit so they're just past my hips. And I'm gonna slide my left knee forward so that it's right up toward my left thumb, but it can't really touch it. I'm gonna stretch the right leg back. I'm gonna let the heel that's underneath me kind of press into the lower part of the glute, upper part of that hamstring underneath the leg there. And then slowly pushing back up, I'm gonna take the foot that's underneath and cross it in front of that back knee and slide the knees together, right? Thigh to thigh into a cross knee position on our hands and knees. Just rock a little bit here. Yeah. You can start to crawl the knees forward if that feels like it's an okay thing to do. If you want to, you could widen your feet and sit back a little deeper. You could stay in a child's pose, or you could walk your hands in, lift the shoulders. I don't think we're gonna sit all the way back, but if you wanted to, you sure could. Right back into our cow's head pose. Okay, one more breath wherever you are. And then uncrossing the legs, I'm gonna crawl my knees back and come all the way down onto the belly once again. And rock a little bit. So I'm gonna let my right knee start to slide sideways off of my mat. I might need to come off my elbows to help my low back manage this pose. Just letting the knees slide. I like to scoot my knee up a little higher so it comes closer to my ribs. You can come as deep as you like here. And you can stay on your belly as much as you want, or roll onto the shoulder opposite of the knee and breathe. Starting to come back out of the pose, stretching the leg out, rocking a little bit. I'm going to crawl my elbows in and push back up to table pose. Feel free to slide into child's pose if you like here. We're just gonna take a few cat-cows. And I'm gonna start to walk my other knee forward. My right knee now is sliding forward. I'm gonna sit on my heel for a moment. See if I can feel the heel underneath me and other leg stretches back. A little bit of a, I call this equestrian pose. It's a little variation on pigeon. And then we're coming up, we're crawling that back knee in again and crossing the front foot over so that we can cross the thighs, cross the knees, slide the legs together. And do whatever works here for you. I like to center my knees a little more, maybe crawl them around a little bit, rock, stretch, sitting back if you like. Gently coming out of the pose, just uncrossing. We're going to come back down onto our tummy, onto the floor. You can reach out now with the other arm. I'm reaching out with my right arm. Left knee is bending sideways off the mat. Maybe walking that knee in closer. Depends on what you like for that. And breathing. Stretching back out, rolling a little bit. I just want to do one more seated pose. Crawl the elbows in, press the hips up, maybe stretch this time into a full child's pose. And I'm going to find something to sit on once again. And come back into the legs stretched out position. Okay, trying to decide how I want to do this. Just rocking a little bit, checking in, making sure everything's nice and loose down there in the low back. I'm just going to take one ankle and cross it over the other. Yeah, just crossing the ankles, letting the inner edges of the feet touch. Lifting the heart, just taking the hands on the knees, sliding them down the shin. Spine is really long. Which leg do you feel the stretch in? Is it the top leg? Is it the bottom leg? Me too. I'm really feeling it in that bottom leg. That's your IT band. Hello again. And as you rock a little bit here, watch the low back so you're not straining it. You don't have to go very far to wake up the sensation along the outside of the leg. Just be careful, kind, experiencing it. Feel the tingle in your toes. And then gently lean back. Uncross the ankles. Rock the feet a little bit. And then maybe try the other leg on top. It's just the ankles that are crossed. Well, kind of the calf a little bit too there. Leaning into it again. Oh, there's the bottom leg. Rocking. And breathing. And coming up. Now you are welcome to do that exact same thing again. Let's take a little butterfly while we talk about what we're going to do as our final little piece of work this morning. So you can just simply cross ankles again, or you can get bigger. We're gonna add a twist to this, to the top of the body. This is a pretty big pose, so, and it can even be bigger, and we're not gonna do the deepest expression. So let's stretch the legs out. Good. I'm going to cross my right ankle over my left, and then I'm gonna start to bend the left knee, sliding the heel along the outer edge of that long leg so I can grab the foot with the opposite hand. I'm gonna take the other hand behind me and start to straighten the leg back out again so that I'm in a twist. And you can play here with that leg. It doesn't have to go high. It doesn't have to straighten all the way out. And please unsquare your hips. Walk the hip back that's connected to the foot you're holding onto. Feel free to grab your strap and use that instead of your hand. All right, and if you wanna hold into the pose, lift the heart, deep breath. Maybe grab that big toe and relax and let the knee bend. You can open it a little, stretch it a little bit. I'm gonna bend it back. Just get that hip opened up again. Good. Stretching it out. Let's try the other side. Remember, you can always just do the ankles crossed this time if you were like, nah. So I'm gonna start by crossing left ankle over and then slide that outer edge of the heel along the legs until I can, along the outer leg, until I can feel that foot. This other hand is gonna go back. I'm walking the butt cheek back. So I'm in my twist and I'm stretching and straightening. Here we go. Watch your shoulders, let them slide down. And when you've had enough, you're just bending, opening that hip, stretching it out. Yes. And we'll roll onto our backs. Feel free to place a blanket under your head. As you relax back on your back, I wanna invite you to try a butterfly pose here, soles of the feet together, but feel free to rock first, rock for a while. Letting the hips, the waist, the glutes, the thighs, letting everything start to neutralize again, come back to natural. Breathing, rocking, the twisting here is so centering, kind of bringing us back to the regular rhythm of the breath. And then if you like the sound of it, you can find butterfly and rest there. If you would prefer a different position, you're welcome. Welcome to be exactly who you are. And I'd like to walk us through one of my favorite meditations. We do it all the time. This is from Good Morning, I Love You by Shauna Shapiro. It's the interconnectedness meditation. Feels good. So rest where you are. Stay in butterfly as long as you like. Come out, do anything else you prefer. I'll just walk us through this gentle meditation. And we'll probably have some good quiet at the end as well. Breathe in the nose, out the mouth a few times, or maybe you're already settled into your natural slow breath. We always begin by allowing the mind and body to find ease. A soft smile to rest upon your lips, simply to invite in peace and rest. And ease. Let yourself notice your breathing again. Just the simple sensation of breathing in and out. The breath is supporting you, oxygenating the body with each inhale, and releasing stress and toxins with each exhale. Maybe you can even sense the beating of your heart, becoming aware of how the heart is supporting you, sending the blood carrying the oxygen and nutrients to all the trillions of cells in your body. Beginning to feel your body upon the floor. Let your awareness expand to include the ground beneath you, supporting you, rising up to lift you. Allow yourself to be aware of the earth beneath that, feeling held by the earth. Feel how there is nothing more you need to do in this moment. And reflect on how the earth is supporting all beings equally, and gravity is keeping all beings tethered to the earth. Reflect on how this earth is connected to a solar system and a vast universe, and that all things, all humans, all animals, the earth, the sun, and the stars, are composed of the same matter, the same basic particles. We are literally all made of stardust. Feel the web of life into which we are born and from which we can never fall. Feel how you are part of the web and nothing is separate. Feel yourself resting in the heart of the universe. Acknowledging your place, feeling your heart, offering yourself love. As you feel that love beating in your heart, begin to extend it outward. Your good wishes moving out from your heart to all beings, gently, silently repeating to yourself, may all beings be peaceful. May all beings be safe and protected. May all beings be happy. May all beings be filled with love and kindness. Recognizing that you are contained within the good wishes for all beings. Resting your attention once again on yourself. Direct the good wishes to your heart. May I be peaceful. May I be safe and protected. May I be happy. And may I be filled with love and kindness. As you breathe in, you are breathing in this loving kindness. And as you breathe out, you are sending this loving kindness out. May all beings here and everywhere dwell with peace. May the earth dwell in peace. And may this practice be of benefit for all beings everywhere. Just rest for a few more moments in silence. Starting your movement back to life by simply opening your eyes and looking around. Let's just hum and om as we move our bodies gently back into this moment. Just vibrating a little bit in our throats here. Hum. Breath in and let it go slowly, beginning to wiggle your fingers and your toes. Feel free to om or hum as you roll over and come back to seated. With an om together, maybe bring your hands in your lap or at your heart. Deep breath in, breathing out, we say om. Thank you and namaste.